हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? शैल स्टार्ट टूडेज क्लास? सपोज यू आर इन द डिपार्टमेंट स्टोर और मॉल विथ योर पेरेंट्स. योर मदर वॉन्ट्स टू बाई सम ग्रॉसरीज. योर फादर वॉन्ट्स टू लुक अप टू सम पेंटिंग्स. यू वॉन्ट टू बाई सम म्यूजिक डिविडीज फॉर योर सेल्फ. यू ऑल थ्री आर इन डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट इन द डिपार्टमेंटल स्टोर और मॉल. वाई? बिकॉज ऑब्जेक्ट इन द स्टोर आर कैटेगराइज इन टू डिफरेंट सेक्शंस अकॉर्डिंग टू योर टाइप्स. सच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज कन्वीनियंट एंड लीड्स टू बेटर मैनेजमेंट. In this lesson, we will learn in detail about the basis of classification of material. What makes life interesting? It is the variety of things. Look around yourself. You see people of different religion, region, speaking different languages, and engaged in different professions, eating different foods, and pursuing different hobbies. That is not all. Here is a variety of all goods that we use in our life. Clothes that we wear of different colors, like red, green, yellow, and blue, etc. The container that we use for storage of groceries are of different shapes. They are conical, cylindrical, cubical, etc. The sofa set and dining table that we use in our homes are made up of wood or plastic. Based on our observation, we conclude that all objects have different shapes, colors, and properties. All objects are made of one or more materials. Clothes are designed from cotton, linen, jute, nylon, etc. We use glass, stainless steel, or plastic crockery in our homes. Furnitures made of wood, plastic, or even iron are used. Leather, plastic, resin materials are used to make bags, shoes, and jackets. Vehicles such as scooter, cars, and buses are made of steels. So, we may say that objects around us are made of large variety of materials. A box is cube or cuboidal in size shape. A ball is a sphere. A laundry bag is cylindrical in shape. Whereas washing machine is cuboidal. Thus, we can say that we can classify object on the basis of their shape as well. Circular and spherical are form one group. Whereas square, cubical, rectangular, and cuboidal form another group. Such a classification allows us to study and analyze the properties of different shapes. The first object we use as soon as we woke up is the toothbrush. Have you ever wondered what it is made up of? It is made up of plastic. The plate that you have meal in is made of melamine or stainless steel. The cupboard in which you keep your clothes or books is made up of iron or cobalt. The book that you read is made up of paper. The shoes you wear are made up of leather, canvas or rexin. Thus, all the objects that we use in our day-to-day life can be classified on the basis of raw material used in making them. The water you drink to quench your thirst is liquid. The food you eat is solid. The chilled juice you relish in summer is liquid. Whereas glass container you have juice in it is solid. The warm milk you had is liquid, but the vapor coming out of milk is gases. Thus, it is clear that we see around us or use in our day life can be classified any one of the three categories, that is solid, liquid, or gases. In all the above example, we have been looking at basis of classification of objects, that is material. Have you ever wondered why such classification is important? In our everyday life, we come across many materials. Sorting materials into group is important in our life because it is easy to locate similar or object by placing them together. Sorting materials into group also facilitates studies of their properties and allow us to observe pattern in their behavior. Let us summarize what we have learned. Object around us are of different shapes, color, and state. Object can be classified on the basis of their shapes and colors. Thus, they can also be classified on the basis of the state of their matter. Yet another basis of classification is the raw material used to create object. Sorting object allow us to locate easily. Sorting object allow us to study their properties. So, till here, if you have any doubt, any issue in understanding any of the content that we have discussed today, you are free to ask me now. So, if you have no issue, then once again I will summarize the topic. Objects around us are of different shapes, color, and state. Objects can be classified on the basis of their shapes and colors. They can be classified on the basis of the state of their matter. Yet another basis of classification is the raw material used to create objects. Sorting objects allow us to locate easily. Sorting objects also allow us to study their properties. So that's all for today. I hope you understood each and every topic. Still, if you have any doubt, any issue in understanding any topic, you are free to contact me. So that's all for today. Thank you. Bye bye.
Safe. Stay home.